in this part of the MOOC, we're talking about the sex steroids, steroid hormones that are involved in the ovaries, the testes, and the whole reproductive system. What I need to just kind of say is that in biology, we kind of treat this as a binary extremes of male and female. That's probably not the case in most people or in any life form. Forgive me if this seems kind of simple, but it's the easiest way to present it. And I know and you know that it's a little more complicated than what we're going to talk about in this particular MOOC. So we're going to start with the ovaries. The ovaries are in the pelvis, and they're just under the pelvic brim, which is kind of right here. There's the pelvic brim, and here is the ovary. You've gone over the fallopian tubes and uterus and all of the other reproductive organs in Dr. Alsop's reproductive MOOC, but here again is the fimbria of the fallopian tube or uterine tube, and here's the uterine tube going to the uterus. The ovary is suspended from the body wall by the suspensory ligament of the ovary, and that contains the ovarian artery vein within it, which are the blood supply for the ovary. So the ovary is another endocrine organ that's that is within the hypothalamus anterior pituitary cascade. So the hypothalamus secretes gonadotropin releasing hormone, or GnRH, as it is abbreviated, and it secretes GnRH into the anterior pituitary. The anterior pituitary makes two hormones, The anterior pituitary makes two hormones, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. These hormones are secreted then from the anterior pituitary and act on the ovary. The ovary, in turn, out into circulation, secretes estrogen, progesterone, relaxin, and inhibin. The anterior pituitary gland secretes luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. Luteinizing hormone stimulates the formation of the corpus luteum. And the corpus luteum is the yellow body. It's formed after ovulation. Luteinizing hormone also stimulates the corpus luteum to secrete progesterone and estrogen. Follicle stimulating hormone, when it acts on the ovary, it stimulates primary follicle development. And the primary follicles are here. So there's a primary follicle, there's a primary follicle. And the primary follicles secrete estrogen. So luteinizing hormone stimulates the formation and maintenance of the corpus luteum, and the corpus luteum secretes progesterone and estrogen. Follicle stimulating hormone stimulates the primary follicles, and they secrete estrogen. So estrogen and progesterone that are secreted by the ovaries have functions throughout the body. Estrogen is responsible for female secondary sex characteristics, so that includes breast development and the deposition of adipose tissue in a kind of a particularly feminine sort of way, and it supports the female reproductive cycle. Progesterone is very important for maintaining the uterus during pregnancy. The other two hormones that are secreted by the ovaries are relaxin and inhibin. Relaxin is secreted at birth or during the birth process and helps loosen up the pubic symphysis to allow the pelvis to kind of open up just a little bit to allow the baby to exit a little bit more comfortably. And it is important for dilating the cervix to allow baby to be born. And inhibin, secreted by the ovary, inhibits the release of follicle-stimulating hormone from the pituitary. So in summary, what I'd like you to understand about the ovary is what hypothalamic releasing factor is related to ovarian function, what two hormones are released from the anterior pituitary that act on the ovary, and what are the actions of these hormones. So think about the different parts of the ovary they act upon. And then what four hormones are made in the ovary, and what are their functions once they're secreted and in circulation. Once you have a grasp on these concepts, then you'll be ready for the assessment.